Hi guys, welcome to the first review of Documentary Week. Today we are looking at a 2011 documentary directed by Keith Allen, of all people, called Unlawful Killing, which goes into a little bit of detail about the death of Princess Diana and the potential of the royal family having something to do with her death. Just come out and say it straight away. I detest the royal family. I detest what they stand for. Why do we need a monarchy in the first place? They rule over all. They're a law upon themselves. I don't know why anyone would want to marry into such a venomous, foul family. So you're probably thinking right now, oh, he's just going to agree completely with whatever was said in the documentary. I still have quite an open mind on this one. Now, conspiracy theories, you know, everyone at some point has a direct opinion on a conspiracy theory that they've heard. But what I liked about Keith Allen's documentary, even though the main narrative is that, you know, could the royal family have something to do with the death, which at this point, I think it would not surprise me. They had the right motives to do so, even before her death, and even during the early stages of the marriage, Prince Philip was sending Princess Diana some very horrible messages. She even said to her butler before she died that she she could see herself being killed and there was a plan to kill her. What I like about the documentary is it doesn't just say, oh, this means this. This person said this, so this means that they say that. They provide a lot of evidence. There's a lot of inconvenient truths that have been revealed because of this documentary. We all know the royal family is linked to the Nazis. There was that whole... It blew up a few months ago with the Queen doing Nazi salutes and stuff like that. So there's stuff there that isn't exactly new, but you do learn some very dastardly things about the royal family. I hate that argument that they bring in tourism. They may well do so, bring in some Chinese tourists every now and then, but the fact that they're such a burden on the taxpayer completely makes that point irrelevant, in my opinion. Getting back on point, there's some really interesting things revealed. The fact that Keith Allen used an undercover journalist to hear what fellow journalists were saying. The fact there was almost a media blackout on certain topics. It also brings up the point that even though it was ruled as unlawful killing, there's really been no arrests. The journalist who was supposedly involved in the death was found with two gunshots in the head and his car burned. How can you do that when you've shot yourself twice the head? How can you burn your car? I don't know. It's just, it brings a lot of arguments that you can't concretely answer if you have any sense of logic or common sense. In terms of style, it's done really well. It uses archive footage, it uses interviews, it uses audio excerpts from Princess Diana herself, it uses scans of documents that were relevant to the case, and it's all put together really nicely, and it's got some nice talking heads from Piers Morgan. I can't believe I'd ever agree with Piers Morgan on anything. They of course talked to Mohammed Al-Fayed, because at the end of the day, he lost a son because of this. I liked the way it was structured. It was nicely done. It had a really nice soundtrack throughout. Some really clever montages put in there as well. There were some reconstructions as well of the actual inquest. It just brought up some really interesting topics, like the fact that a lot of the people involved in the inquest have connections to the royal family, and the fact that Mohammed Al-Fayed had to take the royal crests down from Harrods before he sold it off, which he happily burnt in front of his son's grave, which was really nice and symbolic. And I like it that it didn't hit you over the head with that sympathetic narrative towards Mohammed Al-Fayed. And yeah, it just really gives you a nice insight to a very interesting topic. It gives you enough evidence so you can make your own minds. It asks questions, it doesn't just hit you over the head. It's just a very interesting documentary, and you can watch it on YouTube, and the rest of the documentaries that I'll be reviewing are also on YouTube. So yeah, if you're interested in banned documentaries and controversial documentaries, then definitely give it a look. It's a really entertaining watch, actually, and I've come away with stuff that I had never really thought about or never even knew, and as a whole, has it affected my opinion on her death? Not really. As devastated as it was, she married into the family. She didn't deserve this, of course. You marry into that family at your own peril. Let's hope one day that they will be overthrown and cease to exist, because I think in modern society, you do not need a monarchy. That's just my opinion. But yeah, check it out if you want to see an interesting documentary. If the subject interests you, you've probably seen this already. And yeah, I'd love to hear your thoughts and opinions, not only on the documentary itself, but the subject matter. Apologies, I sound like I'm coming down with a cold. Do you think that the royal family had something to do with the death of Princess Diana, or do you think it's just a very convenient death for the family? Yeah, I'd love to hear your thoughts and opinions. And yeah, I hope you're enjoying this documentary week so far, and I hope you're enjoying the videos that follow this one. Thank you guys for watching, and until the next time, I shall see you later. Thank you.